Let me make this clear. I'd like to share this information because I know there's somebody somewhere who's going through a similar situation and they just think that, oh my God, this is the end of my life. I need a week. Sometimes you relapse, sometimes you just like, you find yourself missing someone so bad that, hey girls, welcome back. Okay, I need to get out of this house. I need to get out of this place. Well, I already did and I'm getting out again. But this time I'm just chatting with you as I get ready, as I prepare, as I pack, and all the girly stuff that you guys love. Yeah, remember to subscribe to the channel. And yes, guys, I am beyond grateful to you guys for all the love and the support you've shown me. Not what I expected, but I'm grateful. So you've really made me feel so comfortable to open up and just really speak to you guys from my heart and some things that I just thought I would never share. But I'm sharing, here we are. And also, remember to follow me on Instagram as well at OchenoRachel8, which is right here, and I'll see you. I'm so active there. So now let's get into the video and get ready for us to have some fun. I just wanted to come here and appreciate Black Beauty for a second. Black Beauty, okay? Ages, don't talk to me. Don't. I'm packing and getting ready for the weekend, kind of. And I just wanted to show you guys what I'm packing right now. I'm very natural. This is what my face, it's not necessarily the greatest, but I'm moisturized, guys. I'm struggling with my sleep. Oh my God, I am really, really struggling with my sleep. My house is really white and it's really bright in here. So at night it's just I have window blinds and all that, but apparently it doesn't work. And I'm not a fan of dark curtains because I just think it's spooky. I like light, so I have to deal with that. Anyway, I don't know if there's a way I can get like white curtains that still blocks out light. Is there something like that? I really need that because at night I'm not sleeping and my face is beginning to pick up on it. So I'm just going to shower, get ready, and then I'll chat with you guys soon. Okay, so here is my dress. It's the blue one. And then I have a white top, basic white top. And I also have like a bodysuit, which I love so much. Both of these are from Zara. And then I have my scarf here. I have a dinner dress in case you're going to eat. And then I have extra comfortable bra. And then some pair of black pants. I have a t-shirt here. And then I have my nightgown. And then I have a pair of matching, you know. Then here on my couch, I have my forever faithful Zara coat. And then I also have this bag, it's also from Zara. Then here I have my Gucci sunglasses. And then I have some sportswear. And then when you come to my bag, here I've put some accessories here. All these are accessories, so I'll put them on top when I'm done packing. Extra perfume. This always just works so easy, so light. And then, oops. And then here just contains the, you know, the oops, be ready. Here I'll put my makeup and all that stuff when I'm done doing my makeup, which I haven't done yet. These are my training shoes. These are my high heels. And basically that's it. And all that is just packed for one day. Meanwhile, I'm here fixing my wig so that I washed it. So it needs some styling. And that one is cooking and getting ready. Aren't you tired of the drama? You use your words like they are knives. I don't need that type of drama. And trying to be tough all the daytime. You try to make yourself feel better by taking me down. Once I fell, but now I'm strong, I'm ready for the rematch.
so cold. Get over yourself, are you for real? Why are you looking at me so cold? One's love is nowhere in the knees.
Guys, I need to do this off camera now. I'll show you guys when it's done. So this side is done. This side is yet to be done. So I'll go ahead and finish it, then show you guys. Okay, so the hair is done. Look at that. Stunning. It smells so good. Look at that. Janet, how are you feeling when you've washed your hair? It smells so nice. This time I made very loose, bouncy curls, like... Not my natural hair.
Sorry, sir. Which hair is that?
My wig.
Huh? The wig is so bouncy.
Yeah, the wig is so bouncy and nice, and now I've made very different curls. Like, usually I make, you know the curls I normally make? But today I've made very tiny, bouncy curls.
You try to make yourself feel better by taking me down. Once I fell, but now I'm strong. I'm ready for the rematch. Shoot me down. Don't you know I get up? Yeah, baby, I will fight. No, there ain't nothing stopping me. I'm bulletproof, I won't fall. I'm bulletproof.
I hope that you won't go see you in the final. Oof. As you do come a wig wearing shenanigans, I'm like, how my hair turned out. Let me just stand and show you from the back. Yeah, I think it turned out really nice. I feel like it's giving me a very different look, because lately I've just been holding my hair at the back and stuff, and I just like how my face looks lately. I think it looks really nice. And I love myself so much. Like, of course I give myself compliments. Of course I notice when I look good. And I won't wait for anyone to do it for me, because I can do it to myself. So when someone tells me, you look beautiful, I'm like, I know. Anyway, I'm going to accessorize just my hands. Use my Dennis Wellington bracelet. I don't know how to show you guys my Dennis Wellington bracelet, and then my, I'm going to use my watch as well. Oh my god, I think finally my other watch can have a break, because now I'm so obsessed with this watch. Like, it's so pretty. Oh gosh. Okay, if you want something similar, I have a link in description, you can get it. And okay, the person who's supposed to pick me up is kind of running late, so I have to wait. I have a moment. And what else do I need? Let me do some Rachel Sparkle here. It's so funny. One of you guys told me that. I love you guys. I just love how you look out for me. So one of you guys told me that I should write down some things that maybe happened in my relationship, so that if I feel like going back to my ex, I shouldn't. I'm like, Sus, I wrote a whole book, I'm telling you. It's not like a lot of bad things happened, but I just wrote things so that I can remember, you know. Sometimes you relapse, sometimes you just like, you find yourself missing someone so bad that you wonder like, should I go back? Anyway, so yes, I wrote a whole book. Not a whole book, but I wrote some things into very detailed information so that if I ever have that a little bit of, you know, that feeling that sometimes you get. And another thing that probably I did not mention is, you know, guys, I'm just sharing. Let me make this clear. I like to share this information because I know there's somebody somewhere who's going through a similar situation and they just think that, oh my God, this is the end of my life. And I can tell you, even when you leave a situation in the most positive, loving manner, there's always that feeling that comes with you, especially if you really like, if it was a real thing. Especially if you're really in love and stuff, there's always a feeling that follows you even when things were not so messy. So it doesn't always have to be crazy and all that for someone to need this kind of tips. And so I think something else that I did or that I am... Wait, I've lost my train of thought now. Whew, side effects of Botox, forgetfulness. Okay, I've always been forgetful anyway. I'm trying to remember what I wanted to say. Anyway, I lost it. But another thing that I have been doing, so like I did or that I was doing during this process, was I decided to repaint my apartment. Actually, I just did the moment I came in here, but it was so therapeutic, you know, taking that brush, and I was just like, this is me repainting my life, this is me redoing my life all over again, I got this, I can't do this, oh, that, and then I'll see the transformation, I'll be like, this is beautiful, and I'll just say like, and I'll be like, this is about to be me, I'm repainting my canvas, I'm going to redo this, and it will be fine. Yes, I remember I wanted to say, yes, the mentality, what have you made this thing mean? Being unbothered and not feeling things is basically being in a constant state of denial. And honestly, I live with my heart on my sleeve. I wouldn't survive as a person who's always in denial. Let me say that. But I have decided to use a different technique. How I look at my situation right now is not like a punishment that, oh my God, I wasted my time. No, I just sit down and I think, okay, we had a great time. We made some mistakes, but we learned from them. And then as we move forward as better and more grown people, we will make better choices, we'll act differently, and hopefully we will have a different outcome. But also, for me, honestly, guys, I haven't been alone in such a long time, because of course I was living with my parents and then I lived with somebody. Like, I haven't just lived alone. And taking this moment to live by myself has been so refreshing, guys. I love my apartment so much. It's my holy place. This is where I just come and get lost and I find myself cleaning. And you know, if you guys follow me, you know, I've not always been like a clean girl. I've been a dirty girl, but not like that. Like, I'm dirty, but not like that. I'm really taking this time to just enjoy being by myself, having a clean house, having a clean white couch, clean white carpet, clean white everything, and not feeling bad if I stain my wall. I own this, I've bought this. Like, I'm so proud of myself. I can go on and on. You guys will be tired. You know, girls, a lot of you keep asking me what happened. What happened? And I don't want to come here and be like, yeah, stop minding my business, mind your business. Well, I put my business here and I know you are entitled. It's fine. I admit that you are entitled and I'm here serving you guys. I know by now you are in season 3, episode, I don't know if it's 3 or 4 of my mess. You are tuned in. You are very supportive. Some of you are cursing me out and that's totally fine. Like, I get this relationship. Like, we have to work through this relationship somehow and just like just like a marriage or whatever, it's not perfect, so we have a little bit of rough edges here and there that we need to work on, and I admit that. But guys, guys, listen, give me a moment. I don't know how to keep quiet. Like, I just find myself exposing things even when I know very well, like, I was not supposed to say this. I find myself saying it. Just give me a moment. One of these days I'll say it. And I see some people like, Rachel, why were you acting like you're such in a perfect relationship and you're not showing us? I'm like, you guys were not watching my vlogs? Like, weren't you guys watching my vlogs? Oh, but I think that people just have this glass lens on how they look at things. But as far as I'm concerned, I showed you guys way too much. Like, if you are listening, if you're really watching and listening, like some of you, you cannot say that statement and mean it, because you know, deep down you know, I said things that maybe some of you by now could have figured out. But I know there's a lot of pressure for me, not pressure, I'm saying pressure because like no one is pressurizing me, I have control of this. But people keep asking me what happened. Honestly guys, at the moment I'll not tell you what happened, but just give me some minutes because I might just say it also, I don't know. And I'm here to share this journey part of me. Like I said, I didn't want to, you know, most people choose to not talk about their situations and stuff when it goes south, but I'm here to speak about it because you guys are some people are constant, you know yourself in this comment section, you know, you're constantly making false videos of me, this and that, but I'm like, you don't need to, because I'm here to spill my own tea. I'm here to say my own thing. I'm just here to tell it all to you good, so we can all move forward, move on. And I also feel like it's a very significant part of my journey, and I'm not in denial of it. I'm not ashamed. I can share, because deep down, I trust myself so much, and I'm so confident of where I'm heading and what I'm going to do and what's forward, that I don't see any shame whatsoever to, I don't know, try to protect things, this or that, look a certain way. Like, I don't care. I'm gonna tell you what I feel inspired to tell you at the time when I'm telling you. So right now, let's go and make some let's go and have some fun outside and not be so sad, which today clearly I'm not. Previously, when I went out, we took the boat and then we went to the water, and then we were just like spending time there, driving along the archipelagos in Stockholm, taking photos and just being in the moment, enjoying. Like, it was really sunny, shiny. It was really sunny on that day, so it was really nice. And then later on the next day, I went to play tennis, and that was so nice. I can't, maybe I just have a photo here. It was actually my first time playing tennis, so I was able to learn a few things here and there. That was so much fun. Like, I really liked it. I liked the experience very much. Yeah, of course, ate some food, oysters. Like, the taste, you know, oysters is not for everyone, but I think I have grown to love oysters so much. And oysters and champagne, oh darling. It's my favorite thing now. Like, I think I can have that every single day. I can be on an oyster and champagne diet and I don't think I'll be tired. And then when you put some Tabasco on it, say no more. So now I don't know what's going to happen, because today the weather is really bad and it's expected to be bad tomorrow also, so maybe there's not a lot of outside activities, but I'll come and give you story time of my, okay, bye guys. Is this is what's up?